Hey, hello Delvin. Welcome to another training video from Accentuate. Today's session is to teach you how to do bill of material using the system itself. It is very simple, very straightforward. For me, I'll be logging into the admin account. For you, you will use the account that we have given to you, alright? So you click on login. Then, of course, for bill of material, it will be under manufacturing. You go to products. Now, in order to create bill of material, right, you will have to have already created your product package. So, I assume that for this particular customer, right, the bill of material is actually for the customer to group several items into one package to sell them. So she sells, let's say for example, product A, B, C, D as one package at one price. So I've already pre-created a few products so that I can do some demonstration to show you. To make it simple, right, I'll just call them A1-something. So A1-package is actually made up of A1-1, 2, 3, and 4. So individually, right, each of these product is going to be sold at $5. So as we can see, they are all sold at $5. Now let's look at the procurement price of these products. Let's say for example this is at $2. Save. This is at $2 also. Let's save this. This is at $2 also. Now, each product, right? When you create a product, you need to take note that you choose the product type, because there are three different types of products that our system can take in. We can take in a stockable product, we can take in a consumable product, we can also take in service products. Now, what are the difference between these three kinds of products? Stockable product, right, the system will be very particular about the stock you have on hand. So if let's say you are trying to create an A1 package and you require a certain amount of A1-1, and if let's say in your warehouse you don't have, the system will not allow you to create that package. But if it is a consumable, then the system essentially don't really care how much you have, you don't have, and it allows the items to go negative. All right, so let's do an example. Say for example, we currently do not have stock for any of these products. So let's take a look. We do not have stocks for any of these products. So let's change them all to consumable. All right. So meaning to say, the system at the moment will not take into consideration the outstanding stocks that you have. So let's change them all to consumable, and we will do one exercise with it so they can see what goes on with the system. So we go back to product. In order to create bill of material, it is very straightforward. You just click on the package. This is the one that is made out of multiple materials, right? So let's say for example A1 package, you just click on bill of material. You click on bill of material, then you create the bill of material. In this case, I've already created one, so I don't have to click create. But if you click on this red button, you will come to this screen. So originally, right, when we have not added in these products, these will be empty. So how to add products, you just click on edit. So the product, you just choose the package that you are trying to create, which is A1 package. Then in order to create one of these package, you will require, say for example, one of -1, -2, -3, and for -4, let's say for example we need two pieces of it to create a package. So we click on save. We can go to manufacturing orders. So let's go back to product and see how many of those A1 packages we have. A1 packages, currently we have got 0 on hand. So let's say we need 20 of them. So we go to manufacturing orders, we click on create, and say we need to create A1 package. The system is smart enough to show you products with only bill of materials. So meaning to, because in the entire list, right, there's only A1 package that needs to be created. So we click on this. Say we want to create 20 packets. Then once we are ready, we click save. And we confirm the production. Now once we confirm production, right, the system will automatically generate to show you how many pieces of each of the items that is required. So in this case, I need 20 pieces of dash 1, 2, and 3. And because dash 4 just now we indicated as we need 2 for each package. So now we run 20 package, we will need 40 pieces of them. We check availability. Now this one, the system will go into the warehouse and see if you have got enough stocks to create this package. Now, do you remember that just now we selected consumable? So consumable, right, the system generally do not restrict on inventory count. So the system is just going to let it go through. Let's click on the check availability. As you can see, they have all become available and we can produce our packages itself. So let's go back to products and go back to A1-package. You will see that currently now we have got 20 pieces on hand. And for the individual items, we have already gone into negative territory, which is what we do not want. So let's change it to stockable and see what happens, alright? Let's reset the quantity on hand to 0 for each and every of them. Reset it to 0. So meaning to say currently we don't have stocks for any of these, alright? And we want to change the product to stockable product, alright? So because we want the system to really look into the stock quantity, we do not want to have negative values or negative quantity amount in the warehouse. So let's change it to stockable product. And just to do a double check to make sure that everything is 0. Okay, now we have done that. So right now they are all stockable products, and rightfully the system will not allow you to carry out any delivery or any sales or any creation of packages if let's say you don't have enough quantity, which makes total sense, right? So let's go to manufacturing orders. Say now we want to create A1 package. We needed 25 packets of them. So we click on save, we click on confirm production. Now the system will tell you that in order to create 25, these are the amount that I need to consume. This time round, let's click on check availability. And as you can see, because they are all stockable products, the system knows that you do not have enough quantity in your warehouse. So it is preventing you from making it available. But if let's say in a real life scenario, right, your customer urgently needs to sell it and she knows that she have got stock, maybe somehow for some reason or whatsoever, she wasn't able to capture the exact quantity of it. So she can use forced reservation. That will force the system to say that to ignore that you have got not enough quantity, so you can produce the packages that you need to produce. So now if we go back to your package, you will see that you have got 45 pieces because we force availability. Now once again, you have gone into negative territory. So on a live scenario, right, it is actually very difficult for us to keep track of every single item, how many stock I have, how many pieces of this I have, that kind of thing. So what our system can do for your customer is that for every single product, right, we are able to set minimum reordering rules. So meaning to say every time when the product falls below a certain quantity, we are able to tell the system that hey, can you order until it hits say 50 pieces. So we go to let's say for example A1, you click on reordering rules. Now we can set a reordering rule to say that in this particular case, right, so let me do that again because it's a bit fast just now. Click on reordering rules. We will come to this page. If a product does not have a reordering rule yet, you can click on create. Now in our case, we already have got one. So we click on this. And this is where we tell the system that every time the product falls below 5 pieces, I want you to trigger a reorder reordering sequence in the system. Then order until what quantity? I want to order until 50 pieces I have in the warehouse. So the system how will the system place orders? So as you can see, currently we have got negative 20 pieces, right? We want to order until we have got, sorry, do we have 20 pieces or do we have 25 pieces? Currently we have got 25 pieces. So we want to reorder until we have got 50 piece. So meaning to say the system will have to place an order of 75 piece in order to meet the quantity level of 50 pieces. So let's do it for this. We have already set the reordering rules. So on a daily basis, the system will automatically run a scheduler. Now this scheduler, we don't have to trigger it to run, it will run automatically. But because right now we are doing a demonstration, so we'll force the system to run the scheduler. So go to warehouse, we click on run scheduler. The system will take a while to populate the order. Now there's one thing that I forget to mention to you. In order for us to successfully automatically create a reordering rule, right? We have to indicate a supplier that the system will buy from. So in this particular case, A1-1, the supplier is A1 supplier. So we have to assign a supplier to the particular product so that the system knows who to buy from. So just now we have already run the scheduler. We go back to purchases. You will see that the system automatically already raised a purchase order. So we click on this. And in this case, right, because we have got reordering scheduler for 1-2 also, so what happens is that the system automatically tells us that we have to order up 1-2. It is the same rule, so we have to keep 50 pieces of it. 1-2 have got negative 25 piece. We are going to order 75 piece so that we will pad it up all the way to 50 pieces. Now you will see the two red buttons up here, send RFQ and print RFQ. We do not need to click on these buttons because what are these buttons for? These buttons are for requesting for quotation. So when we use that, right, essentially what the system will do is that it will go into the RFQ stage whereby we will wait for vendors to give us quotation, then we will key into the system, study them, then award it to one of the vendors. But we are not going to do that, we are just going to straight away confirm the purchase. So you just click on confirm order and then the system will automatically says that okay, we are going to receive 75 pieces of 1 and 75 pieces of 2 from the A1 supplier. So we can click on receive products. So when the products come, we do a stock take, everything correct, there's no spoiled pieces or whatsoever, we can do a transfer and say that we successfully receive all of them. And then once we are done, that's it. The item is transferred into the warehouse. And if we go to products and we type A1-, you will see that because we ordered for A1 and we ordered for product 1 and product 2, now we have got quantity of 50 on hand. All right. Now the purchase is not complete yet because we are still pending invoice receiving from the vendor. So we can go back to purchases, purchase order, click on this. Over here, right, we can say receive invoice. Now when we click on receive invoice, this is where we can say what is the invoice date, the supplier invoice number is what, and this is where we do it. So we click save and just carry on with the invoicing process and you should be fine. All right. So thank you for watching, Delvin. If you have got any other questions, do let me know. I'll do my best to create as many of such training videos for you as possible, so that along the way, as you become better and more competent with our system, and of course, as you gain more confidence in Accentuate that we can deliver systems and we can train your customers, you'll be able to refer modules for us, and we hope to work more closely together with you. So thank you so much, Delvin. Thank you for being our customer. Thank you. Bye bye.